DSR or daily sales report is a management tool which is used to record sales, transaction, APC or APT on daily, weekly, monthly or yearly basis. Even we can track ideal versus actual sales, means sales achieved versus sales target. In today's video, we will see how we can create DSR or daily sales report for multiple units. Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Mom. Let's start the video without any delays. This is a DSR report or daily sales report which I have already created in advance. The months will be managed by drop-downs. Years will also be managed by drop-downs. Once the month will change, the start date and end date will automatically change. In case you want to highlight some days, you can select from here. If you want to highlight 2 days, you can select second day from here. This DSR report is for 5 units or 5 stores. In the end, we can see consolidated report. When we will come in the month of February, the days after 28th are highlighted as well as restricted. We will not be able to insert anything over here. When we will change the month, the days as well as highlights will automatically change. Here I have inserted 12 sheets for 12 months. When we come in the end, we can see consolidated report and that is year to date report. In the end, we can see consolidated yearly report of all the 5 units or 5 stores. Let's start creating a new sheet now. This is the blank format for all the unit or stores. There is no formula of formatting in this sheet. So we will start creating our sheet now. Over here, we will insert months and months will be managed by drop downs. So we will go in data, data validation. From here, we will select list and we will type name of the months from Jan to December. Now we will do OK and our dropdown is created. Now we will start creating dropdown for years. We will go in data, data validation. From here we will select list and over here we will type years. We will do OK and our dropdown is created now. Over here we will insert formula for start date and the formula will be plus or equal to date value, bracket open, double inverted comma 1, double inverted comma close, and we will select this means month and we will select year. We will close the bracket and we will do enter. And our first date is over here. 2. We will insert formula for end date over here and the formula will be plus or equal to EOMONTH, EO month means end of the month, bracket open. We will select this means first date, comma, 0 and we will close the bracket and we will do enter. And our last date is over here. When we will change the month, the first date and last date will automatically change. We will keep it Jan, serial number, we will insert from 1 and we will drag this. Date plus or equal to, we will select this and we will do enter. For second date, our formula will be plus or equal to if bracket open, first date is smaller than our last date, we will insert dollar in our last date, function FO, comma, first date plus 1, comma, double inverted comma 2 times, we will close the bracket and we will do enter. Now we will drag this till end. Here we can see all the dates. We will change the month, February. After 28th, we are not able to see anything as it's blank. We will modify our formula and we will insert EOM over there. I'll click over here between 2 inverted comma and I'll type EOM and I'll do enter. Now I'll drag this till end. And after 28th, we can see EOM written over here. When we will change the month, EOM will vanish. When we will come in the month of April, after 30th, we can see EOM means end of the month. We will be in Jan. We will insert formula for day and the formula will be plus or equal to text, bracket open. We will select this, comma, double inverted comma, DDD, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, and we will do enter. And we will drag this till end. When we will change the month, after 28th, we can see EOM in date as well as days. When I'll change the year, I'll do it 2024. After 29th, in the month of February, it's showing EOM because 2024 is leap year. I'll do it 2023 and Jan. Now we will highlight our EOM. I'll be coming in the month of February. I'll select the whole sheet from here. I'll be going in home, conditional formatting, new rule, classic, and from here we will have to select use a formula to determine which cells to format. And our formula will be plus or equal to, we will select the day, means first day, we will remove the dollar from here, is equal to double inverted comma EOM double inverted comma close. We will go over here in the drop down and we will be going to custom format, fill. From here we will select red color and we will do OK. OK, and our EOM got highlighted. When we will change the month, the highlights got vanished. Now we will restrict EOM as we don't want anyone to insert anything or any data after month end or end of the month. I'll come over here and I'll be going to data, data validation. From here we will select custom and we will insert our formula. Our formula will be plus or equal to, we will select this, means first day of the month. We will insert dollar behind D, smaller than, greater than, double inverted comma, EOM. And we will close double inverted comma. We will do OK and we will drag this till end. We will drag this to our fifth store or unit. So this is done. Now we will insert something over here in EOM and we are getting alert that we are not able to insert anything. I'll cancel it. Now we will highlight our days and our highlights will be managed from here. Now we will click over here. We will go to data, data validation. From here we will select list and over here we will type name of days. We will do OK and we will drag this. We will highlight both. We can select our days from here now. We will merge this and we will type select days from here to highlight. We will put some color over here. Now we will attach these two with our data. We will have to select our whole data, means from store 1 to store 5. I'll minimize it. I'll select all and I'll be going to conditional formatting. New rule, classic, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And we will put our formula over here. And our formula will be plus or equal to, we will select the first day, we will remove second dollar, is equal to, we will select our day from here. You can select your color from here, either from these three or by going in custom format. So I'll select green color from here and we'll do OK. And our Mondays got highlighted. Now we will select this once again and we'll be going to conditional formatting, new rule, classic. Use a formula to determine which cells to format and over here we will insert our second condition, plus or equal to, we will select the first day, we will remove dollar from here, equal to, and we will select this cell from here and this time we will select red color and we'll do OK. So our format got connected with these two cells. Now we will change the days from here, Saturday, and our Saturdays got highlighted. I'll highlight my Sunday also, and our Saturdays and Sundays got highlighted. In case you want to highlight only one day, you can delete Sunday from here and only Saturdays will be highlighted. You can highlight some other day also. In case you don't want to highlight any day, you can delete this from here and it will be blank without any color format. Now we will insert our formula, sales. I'll put a random figure. Tickets or transaction, I'll put a random figure. Formula for APC will be plus or equal to sales divided by transaction or tickets. Enter. I'll select Jan over here. Now we will drag this. One thing more to highlight. In case our figures will not be over here, our format is looking very shabby. So we will have to insert if formula over here. If bracket open sales is equal to 0 comma double inverted comma 0 double inverted comma close comma and we will close the bracket and we will do enter. Now we will drag this till end and we can see 0 over here in case our format is blank. Sales target, I'll insert a random figure over here. Sales, a random figure once again. Tickets, random figure. I'll drag this till end. Target versus achieved. The formula for target versus achieved will be plus or equal to total sales minus sales target. And we will drag this till end. We will insert formula of if over here also. If bracket open sales is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, we will close the bracket and we will do enter. Now we will drag this till end. I have inserted formula of if over here because I don't want anything to be visible if my sales and tickets will be blank. I'll delete this. I'll delete tickets from here. I'll delete sales target. I'll copy this all and we'll paste in the second unit or store. We'll paste in third also. We'll paste in fourth and we'll paste in fifth. So formula for APC and target versus achieved sale is inserted in all the units or stores. I'll freeze the pane. I'll be going in view and I'll freeze the pane. We will come down and we will do total. So formula for total will be plus or equal to sum bracket open. We will select from first day to 31st, close the bracket and we will do enter. Average plus or equal to average bracket open. We will select from first to 31st. Close the bracket and we will do enter. We can see DIV written over here. So we will insert formula of if this is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, and we will close the bracket, enter. So now it's 0 over here also. We will select this and we'll drag till end. Whatever will not be required, we can delete it later. Total of APC is not required, so I'll delete from all the stores. Now we will insert formula for total sales and the formula will be plus or equal to, we will select the first store plus sales of second store plus sales of third store plus sales of fourth store plus sales of fifth store and we will do enter and our formula got inserted. Total tickets, we will drag this. For target and target versus achieved also, we need the same formula, so we will drag this. For APC, we will delete from here. Formula for APC will be plus or equal to total sales divided by total tickets or transaction and we will do enter. We can see DIV over here. If we want, we can insert the formula of if total sales is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, and we will close the bracket, enter. And it's showing 0 now. We will drag this till end. Total sales and average sales, the formula will be same, plus sum bracket open, we will select from first date, bracket close, enter. For tickets or transaction, we will drag this, we will paste same formula over here, average plus AVERAGE, average, bracket open, we will select from first date to last date, bracket close and we will do enter. We will drag this, we will drag this also, we will put if over here. If sales is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, bracket close and we will do enter. We will highlight our weekends over here. So all the formulas got inserted in our master sheet. Now we will insert 12 sheets for 12 months. Our 12 sheets got inserted. We are not going to rename the sheets one by one. We will come in sheet 1 and we will click over here and we will type DSR master sheet. Over here we will type consolidated and below that we will type name of the months. Jan. Now we will drag this till December. Now we will paste a code to rename all the sheets. This is the code which we are going to paste over there. We will copy this. We will come to our Excel file. We will go in developer tab. Over here we will click visual basic. Now we will click on insert and we will insert our module. We will paste the code over here and we will run it. Now we will close our window and all the tabs got renamed. I'll provide link of the code in description box. You can download it from there. Now we will come over here and we will delete this. We will come in our DSR master sheet what we have created right now. We will copy this, Control C or Command C, and we will select tabs from Jan to December. We will click on first tab means on Jan and we will press shift and we will click on December. Now we will go to home and over here in the left hand side we get the option of paste and we'll paste the data over here in the first tab. So once the data got pasted in first tab, all the tabs got updated. We can see means December also got updated. So this is the easiest way to insert same data in multiple tabs. We will take this consolidated in the end after December. Now we will connect consolidated sheet with all the months. Now we will click over here, plus or equal to, we will go in the first month and we will click over here. Means on the sales of first day of the month. Plus, we will go in Feb, we will select this, plus March, we will select the sales, plus April, plus May, plus June, plus July, plus, and in the same way, we will connect all the sheets. And we will do enter. Now we will drag this till end and we will drag this till fifth unit or fifth store. We will delete APC from here and we will insert the formula plus or equal to sales divided by tickets. Enter. We will insert if over here, sales is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, and we will close the bracket. Enter. Now we will drag this till end. We will copy this and we will paste in all the stores. So the consolidated sheet got connected with all the months. Now we will insert formula for consolidated yearly sales. It will be plus or equal to sales of first unit plus sales of second unit plus sales of third unit plus sales of fourth unit plus sales of fifth unit, and we will do enter. We will drag this till end. We will delete this and we will insert formula plus or equal to sales divided by tickets. Enter. We will insert if over here. If bracket open, sales is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, and we will close the bracket in the end. Enter. Now we will drag this till end. We will insert formula for total. We will go in home and we will click on sum. Enter. Average plus average, bracket open, we will select from first to last date, bracket close, enter, and we will drag this. Total of APC is not required, so we will delete this. We will have to insert if over here. If bracket open, sales is equal to 0, comma, double inverted comma, 0, double inverted comma, close, comma, and we will put a bracket in the end, enter. Now we will copy this and will paste in APC of all the stores. So our DSR or daily sales report got created for multiple unit or stores. I'll provide link of this file in my description box. If you want, you can download it from there. I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then, bye-bye.